London, a thriving population of more than 8 million people, using more than 20% of the UK's entire energy demand. Millions of homes and businesses depend on this power every day, yet few know how it's delivered. And with demand for electricity in London increasing as the capital grows in size, it's vital that we upgrade the ageing infrastructure to provide London with a safe, reliable supply of electricity for the future. Keeping up with the rapidly growing electricity demand is no easy task, and National Grid, together with key construction partners, is investing nearly £1 billion to create more than 32 kilometres of huge underground tunnels that will house brand new 400,000 volt cables that will keep London running for the next 50 years and improve access to traditional and renewable energy sources. The cable tunnels are located between 20 and 60 metres deep below the City of London and are between 3 and 4 metres in diameter. The first runs 20 kilometres from Wealdstone substation in northwest London through St John's Wood, St Pancras and Haringey to the substation at Hackney in east London. The second runs 12 kilometres south from Kensal Green down to Wimbledon substation in southwest London. Along the route, National Grid has constructed 14 access shafts, each of which took up to 3 months to dig. These shafts not only provide an easy way for teams to reach the cables, but also allow vital ventilation and have been designed with head houses to minimise their impact on the surrounding areas. The tunnelling itself has been a massive undertaking, with hundreds of years of existing infrastructure to work round, including the underground, Victorian water mains and future paths of the new Crossrail and super sewer developments. National Grid have used two specialist tunnel boring machines, or TBMs, named Cleopatra and Evelyn by local schoolchildren. Each TBM was lowered down one of the access shafts in sections and then put together, allowing the team to bore their way along the tunnel routes, moving some 1,300 tonnes of earth each day for 3 years. As Evelyn and Cleopatra drill through the ground, earth is transferred along conveyor belts and into mining carriages, then out to the surface, through shafts built along the route. Then a sophisticated robot builds concrete rings to line the tunnel wall behind the boring machine as it moves along underground.
We're here at our Kensal Green site. This is where our 3 metre tunnel boring machine Evelyn broke through, completing our 32 kilometres of tunnelling underneath the streets of London. This allows then the north-south section for cabling activities to commence, and we've also seen the first phase of our commissioning take place.
This new tunnel cable network connects 4 existing substations across the city, and 2 new substations are being constructed at Highbury and Kensal Green, which are the first substations National Grid has built in central London for more than 30 years. The substation at Kensal Green has already been energised, ready to power the new Crossrail project, and at Highbury, the most innovative substation National Grid has ever built is under construction.
What we're having to do in London is to think of ways and means of using smaller equipment, compact equipment, and also to look at ways where we can use new technologies. At Highbury, we've installed coolers on the roof as a part of cooling the transformers. Traditionally, we'd have a transformer and a cooler bank, but we're now not only saving space, but we can now reclaim the heat. And that means that we can give that heat then to the local school, that it's a significant contribution to reducing our carbon for both the build and for the operation of the site.
Work is currently underway to install nearly 200 kilometres of high voltage cable in the tunnels, with the first circuit from Kensal Green to St John's Wood already energised. The rewiring of the capital with this brand new 400 kV cable will future-proof London for further infrastructure projects in the coming years.
Installing 200 kilometres of HV cable comes with its risks. There's a lot of stored energy and force in manipulating and moving that amount of cable around some pretty tight urban sites. Each cable is delivered from Germany and weighs somewhere between 35 and 40 tonnes. Those cable drums are then paid off down a tunnel shaft 30 metres below ground onto two specialised machines which are used then to tow the cable into its final position and fix it within the tunnel system. So far it's gone very well. We're very pleased with the technology we've employed to get the cable in and pay the cable off within the tunnel system.
A project of this magnitude wouldn't have been possible without the support of local people. National Grid has recognised this and throughout construction has been committed to working with communities along the tunnel route through the Education Energy Centre at Channelgate Road and a partnership with the charity City Year. More than 25,000 pupils from local schools have been engaged across the capital, inspiring the future engineers of the UK.
I think being on London Power Tunnels has really helped me develop in various different ways. Being on a major project as your first job, you're just bound to learn a lot.
My skill set has massively increased because I have to get involved in so many different elements across the board. There's so many contractors all the time that I have to engage with. A lot of personal skills have developed in that front, trying to meet their needs, but them also meeting my needs.
I think I've gained a lot of project management skills. I know how to work with various different contractors now, and I feel very ready to continue all that I've learned within London Power Tunnels and use that on another project within National Grid.
This project is a major success story, which will be delivered on time, on budget, and most importantly, delivered safely.
This huge investment that we're making will create an energy superhighway for London, bringing in new sources of energy from both renewables and alternatives in the most efficient manner possible. Our people are at the heart of this project. Everybody makes an individual and significant contribution. And it's bringing all that expertise together that actually makes London Power Tunnels such a success.
National Grid is continuing the vital cable installation in the rest of the tunnel, set for full energisation in 2018, delivering power safely to meet London's increasing electricity demand.